Ladies and gentlemen, the program will begin momentarily. As a courtesy to the presenters and audience, please turn off your mobile devices at this time. Thank you.
Hello, welcome to Porting Cordoba on Tizen 2.0 session. My name is Paul Plaquette. I am a senior software engineer working at Intel Open Source Technology Center in France, in Montpellier. I will talk a little bit about me, what is my past, about Cordoba, why we are interested in Cordoba, how we are going on Cordoba, and after we should have a little Q&A session. I am a senior software engineer, I already said that. I have over 24 years of experience. I started as a Macintosh developer. We were working in France on a software called JazzDent, that was used by about 6,000 dentists. It was a dental software administration and imagery software. Then I started to work for Palm Computing and then Palm Source. Palm Source is not Palm One, because Palm Computing was split into Palm Source and Palm One, and Palm One eventually became Palm, and they developed WebOS, and they were bought later by Hewlett-Packard, and now WebOS is in the hand of LG. And after that, I worked for a Japanese company that bought Palm Source, called Access Systems, where we developed Access Linux platforms. I am mostly a middleware and application developer, involved in UX design, design patterns, C, C++, and so on. Since 2010, I started to work at Intel Open Source Technology Center, first on MIGO, then on Tizen, and I was involved to port Cordoba on Tizen, and became a Cordoba committer in last December. So Cordoba, I will talk about what is Cordoba, about the Cordoba release stream, Cordoba platforms supported, and I will say a word about the next version of Cordoba, that is Cordoba 3. Cordoba was inspired from the W3C DAP API, that are about providing web APIs to grant HTML5 application and HTML applications to interface with the device features in the larger meaning, because it is about sensors like accelerometer, geolocation, but also about calendaring and contact. Cordoba is an Apache Software Foundation project, so it is an open source project following the Apache Software Foundation 2.0 licensing. And it is a JavaScript cross-platform framework. We are having a very strong and active community of about 40 committers. Committers are maintainers, actually, in the Apache Software Foundation. We can develop hybrid applications on most of the platforms that are supported by Cordoba, except the web runtimes, because we cannot build C++ applications on C++ or say native applications. The current versions at the end of the month will be the version 2.8. Currently, it is still the 2.7 that is downloadable on the infrastructures of Apache and for Cordoba and for PhoneGap. A pluggable architecture is being developed, and it should be final in the version 3 of Cordoba. The Cordoba release stream is something that is that consists to increment the versioning of Cordoba by .1 each month. So it is not something that is based on features. Of course, the community is working on having features ready. The community is having some goals. For example, deliver the Cordoba 3 in July. So this is a goal, and it is quite ongoing for now. So in May, we are going to have, at the end of the month, the version 2.8, and in July, version 3. A word on Cordoba platforms. Oh, I forgot to say that the monthly release are supporting only Cordoba platforms. This is important, and this is why I will talk about Cordoba platforms. So there are many platforms supported by Cordoba. I listed these here. So Android, Bada, BlackBerry, BlackBerry 10, just added, Firefox OS, iOS, OS 10, Qt, Symbian, Tizen, WebOS, Windows, both 7 and 8, Windows Phone 7 and Windows Phone 8. The community is defining a notion of core platforms, sunset platforms, and sunrise platform. Core platforms are the platforms that are supposed to be in the monthly release. So for now, they should be iOS, Android, Windows Phone, BlackBerry. I think WebOS is still in the core platforms, but it should be removed. At least it is that said the wiki page about sunset platforms. So sunset platforms are Bada, for example, and WebOS. Both for two different reasons. Bada is because Samsung told that it should be replaced by Tizen. And WebOS because with the acquisition of LG, it is going to be a web TV OS, maybe. We don't know exactly what it is became. It will become. And anyway, there will be no devices, so it is clearly that is interesting the community to have devices to build application on. There are sunrise platforms like Tizen, of course, Firefox OS, Qt, OS X, and Windows. So the community is interested by desktop platforms also. Cordoba 3 is a new modular architecture where everything will be plugins, including the legacy Cordoba APIs. The implementation is already started, and it is using also a command line interface tool, CLI, that is using another tool called Plugman that is actually capable of gathering the plugins that you have in your project. It should be ready in July, and you could have more information about PhoneGap Days US in Portland, in Oregon, in July, and there will be a replay of this conference in Amsterdam in September this year. So why we get interested into developing Cordoba on Tizen? So there are many reasons. First, the relationship between Cordoba and Adobe, Cordoba and Intel, Cordoba and Tizen. So first, let's see what is the relationship between Cordoba and Adobe. Originally, the PhoneGap was made by a small Canadian company based in Vancouver called Nitobi. Adobe bought Nitobi in 2011. And the name at that time changed from PhoneGap to Callback and finally Cordoba. Cordoba is the open source project and following the Apache Software Foundation licensing to zero. And PhoneGap is an Adobe distribution relying on Cordoba. PhoneGap build system is based on using PhoneGap. And PhoneGap build system is a kind of cloud that you can use to package HTML applications for every supported platforms that are included in PhoneGap build, so in PhoneGap. Intel is interested in Cordoba. Intel engineers contributed actually to Windows 7 entirely and participated into providing Windows 8 support. I am talking about the desktop there. And Tizen port. And we last year we went to have up to 8 engineers involved in this project, 3 on Tizen and the others on Windows 7 and Windows 8. We are having 3 Cordoba committers since last December, so I am one of them. Porting Cordoba on Intel is a part of the HTML5 strategy of Intel to enable web applications. When I say HTML5 strategy, it is about web technology, actually. So everything that is involved in running an HTML application, a web application on a platform. Intel OTC has to sign the CLA, Company License Agreement of the Apache Foundation, and also each engineer signed the Individual Contribution License Agreement that is about the renouncing to IP for the profit of the Apache Software Foundation, mostly. We have a page, a Cordoba page, in the 01.org Intel OTC website. That is redirecting people to the main Cordoba Apache website. So Cordoba and Tizen. Tizen is is a platform of choice for Cordoba because we want to take benefit of Cordoba application portfolio. We want to attract developers to Tizen. And also to grant Tizen developers to go cross platforms easily if they wish to address other platforms than Tizen with their HTML5 applications. We would like to take benefit of tools like PhoneGap Build Systems, so integrate Tizen into PhoneGap Build. We want to build a community of Tizen developers using Cordoba, and the goal is obviously to take more applications to Tizen. So, how did we go on Tizen? I'm going to say a word on how we did port Tizen. The first, what is the port on Tizen? What are the supported APIs? We'll see where are the repositories, Git repositories, on Apache and on GitHub, some websites. What is the current status? What are the next steps? And then why your developers are needed and how we can help and how to contact me if it is needed. So porting on Tizen. Tizen is having a web runtime composed of W3C APIs and Tizen device web APIs. Web APIs are really APIs of choice to develop applications on Tizen. Cordoba on Tizen was port as a JavaScript shim layer that is adapting Cordoba APIs to the Tizen APIs. It is mostly following design patterns like proxy or adapter. Previous ports on Tizen SDK was ready in last August, and it was running on Tizen SDK 1.0. We were waiting since that time to the SDK 2.0 to be able to make this evolve. And we are using only publicly released SDK for Tizen. So now it was Tizen SDK 2.0, and soon it should be Tizen SDK 2.1. It was released, became the official release last week. So I did not have yet the time to get into that. What are the supported APIs? And by the way, it is about a milestone I have in the project of adapting Cordoba to Tizen. So the first phase is an adaptation phase of the existing port on Tizen SDK 2.0. So we are going to support every APIs supported on the previous port we did that are accelerometer, battery, camera, with a partial implementation only. Compass, connection, contact, device, file and file transfer, geolocation, media, notification and storage. For geolocation, storage, and media, it is straightforward because it is using W3C APIs that are directly supported by at the same time by Cordoba and on Tizen. So there is nothing to do. This phase is under execution and doing well, as it was finished just before the conference. The next is about extending, that is supporting any newly added APIs that can have in Cordoba since the last port, that are in App Browser, Globalization, Splash Screen, Notifications, but to provide a prompt dialogue with a native user interface on Tizen, and improve error handling, and unifying in error handling with a newly added APIs. The good news is that the inner browser that it was about opening a web view inside the web view is already running as it was done in JavaScript. The last phase of adaptation is, I called it fulfilling. It will about improving Cordoba interaction between Cordoba APIs and Tizen platform itself. We have actually to finish any partially implemented API that are camera, capture, events, and miscellaneous. Events are about on managing hard keys that we have on a device, and miscellaneous are something like dialing a phone number, sending a SMS, and so on Tizen, we should be able to use a native service provided by a native application running through the application control Tizen web API. The repositories, the repositories are there are both parts. One is more for committers and is available on the Apache Git in repositories infrastructures. Committers can have access right to do anything they want in these repositories. And these repositories are mirrored on the GitHub website. And this GitHub service is more for contributors that can use pull requests to provide patches and fix and enhancements to Cordoba. So pull requests are working by first cloning an existing repository on GitHub, and then you make a branch with Git, you work on your features, you pull the request with a branch, and then a committer will come, maybe more, depending on the interest of the community. You can advertise your change on the Cordoba mailing list. And last but not least, the repositories of interest for Tizen are Cordoba-JS and Cordoba-Tizen. Cordoba-JS is about the Cordoba main project that is building and supporting all the platforms that we can have in Cordoba. And Cordoba Tizen is about to provide more sample code adapted to the platform targeted, so Tizen. There are some websites. So the Cordoba website, the cordoba.apache.org, there is also a wiki that is going to give you more information on the inner structures and on the way that people have to work with within Cordoba at the Apache Foundation. The PhoneGap website and the PhoneGap build website from Adobe are also of interest, as in a way it is the same project, kind of same project, even if it is more commercial for Adobe. And there is also a PhoneGap user forum on Google that is about helping developers that are using PhoneGap or Cordoba to develop applications. The Cordoba mailing list is on its side more for people who are involved in developing Cordoba, who are willing to get some news on how they can influence the roadmap for Cordoba and so on. So you can, if you want to provide new features, to ask for new features, it is. You can go on the Cordoba mailing list. If you have a question on how you can use Cordoba within your application, then it's more of a user forum. Oops. Oh, yes. Okay. The current status. So I already said that the first set of APIs were already committed. I still have bugs in file and file transfer. Actually, in Cordoba, we have an application that is called Mobile Spec that is doing some unit testing and providing a report of bugs or features that are not well supported. And for now, with file and file transfer, I have 40% of failures, so it's not that good, but it does not prevent the Cordoba from bootstrapping within your application. The work on the second set of API should start ASAP, still after the conference, once I am back to my office. And Cordoba in App Browser API is working already, and I already tested all the adaptation to the SDK 2.0, and I saw that it was working on Cordoba 2.1. And the only change is minor things in the config XML file in Tizen. So now let's see what are the next steps. The next steps are obviously to support Tizen SDK 2.1, to build a native plugin sample that you could use the NP API and NP runtime on Tizen. Maybe more of a message port if we need to interact more with a background-only native application, but I think it would be more about using NP API, actually. I have to update the documentation, to update samples, to adapt the command line interface tool to Tizen, to adapt the plugman tool to Tizen, and then we will be able to integrate Cordoba 3. Cordoba 3, as I said, is about to split everything into plugins. So the Cordoba managers, Cordoba APIs themselves, are going to be plugins. And any third parties could add its own plugins through packaging systems. And after that, the idea will be to have all the plugins you need in your project, and then Plugman is able to assemble all the files you need into a similar architecture, in a similar archive. But again, you will have more information in July when Cordoba 3 will be released and exposed to the public at PhoneGap Days. Then there's another bunch of steps that I call precogs. If you are a fan of sci-fi, you know that precogs are Philip K. Dick mutant with precognitive capacities. You saw them in Minority Report. These are steps that do not depend only on just porting Tizen, Cordoba and Tizen. We would like to have Tizen to become a core platform of Cordoba. We want to build a Cordoba community around Tizen, around Cordoba on Tizen. We would like to have Tizen in Adobe PhoneGap, and we would like to have Tizen in Adobe PhoneGap Build. So these steps are dependent on succeeding to release devices. This should occur soon. To have the interest of developers, hopefully it should come with devices. Even above all, if it is a success, and then to have the interest of Adobe in adding Tizen in PhoneGap, in PhoneGap Build. So of course, everything is out now to make this happen. We have a SDK. We are going to have devices, so we should have interest for developers who would be willing to port their application on Tizen using Cordoba. And if we have developers, if we have devices, we should get the interest of Adobe. So this is why you are needed, you the developers. You can participate into the Cordoba mailing list if you want to influence or ask or trying to help, and knowing how you can help, you can ask questions in this mailing list. You can ask for features, new features. You can eventually propose new features or new API, for example, and propose an implementation of this. You can find bugs, enter Jira ticket, that is the issues tracking system that is used by Apache Cordoba. You can report bugs. Also, you can fix bugs. It's even better, and at that time you are starting to become a contributor. and you can eventually become committers and get the access rights on all the Apache repositories, not only for Tizen, but for any other platforms you would be involved into. If you want, you can contact me also, if you have more questions specifically on Tizen, but also on Cordoba, through the Cordoba mailing list, or even by direct email. I listed in the slides both email. Apache.org is actually redirected into intel.com mail, so it's the same. Thanks to hearing me. And now we may have a small session of questions and answers.
I have a question about the divergence of the releases from Cordova and Tizen. So Tizen SDK 1.0, 2.0, 2.1, 3.0, Cordova 1.68, mm-hmm. blah, 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 blah. We're at 2.7 now. And it seems to be very, very difficult to time the releases. Do you have a plan to improve that?
The Cordova release train is to increase the versioning each month. So I have no hand on that. After for sure we will have an issue with versioning once we will have devices released on a version of the SDK. For example, PhoneGap build is supporting Cordova PhoneGap starting from version 1.9 of PhoneGap. So for example, if we want to integrate PhoneGap, we will have to support several implementations and several ports of PhoneGap on Tizen, starting from the first that will be released on a device. So I'm not completely answering to your questions, but we will probably have to work this out to improve the versioning with PhoneGap build. And we are already having the interest of Adobe for to integrate PhoneGap build. So.
Check, okay. For the Tizen Cordova plugin library, are you relying, is it on top of native Tizen or is it running over Tizen Web API?
For being native on Tizen, the issue is not about the port of Cordova itself. It is more about how the platform is going to support native access. So on Tizen, you are going to have two ways to do that. One is using the NP runtime that is actually implementing NP API. So it is something quite classical in a web browser. And the other is to use a message port that grants you to communicate both ways with native applications. So first, I will try to implement and to show how we can develop an NP API plugin. And then I will start to look if something can be done using the message port and using a background-only applications with no user interface to provide a service.
So the current library that you have is over Tizen Web Runtime, or?
Yes. It will be using the features of Tizen Web Runtime to provide native access. Yes.
Okay. So if we wanted to add a native functionality which is not part of PhoneGap, these are called the plugins in PhoneGap.
The plugins will be for Cordova 3, but for now you are going to have a JavaScript part of a plugin that is integrated in the Cordova library, and then the native part rely on how the platforms grant you to access to native. So on any platforms that you have on Cordova, each platform is actually providing its own hook to access to a native code and to get back from native code to to the JavaScript part using JavaScript calls and events and things like that. And it is often different from one platform to another. On Tizen, we first plan to use the NP API, so it is only one way, that is activating a plugin that is going to work natively. And there is this message port possibilities to communicate with background-only applications, but we are not sure that we can use that. But for sure, it would be interesting because it would be a both-way communications layer between your native code and the JavaScript layer. But the first will be to use first step will be to use NP API through NP runtime on Tizen, through sample code actually, because it's not really a part of the port itself.
Okay, thanks.
I have a quick question. Sorry for my ignorance of Cordova and Tizen and everything, but should we expect some sort of performance degradation when you're using Cordova? I mean, what is the performance of a Cordova app on Tizen, maybe say versus a regular web app on Tizen, and do you have any data or insight into that question? Mm-hmm.
Actually, when we first tried to do the port on Tizen 1 SDK, we tried to make a prototype using a C++, C and C++ layer. And the issue we are facing with this are several. First, the services that were available through the web view that we can open were not exactly the same than you can have using a web browsing view using the web browser. In Tizen, and different from the what we can have in the web runtime. I don't know if this was fixed, but the major issue was not this one, actually. It was rather that for a long time, Samsung always told us that the main APIs were web runtime. And so the goal is to propose developers to sell their applications through an app store, and to sell web applications that could be installed through an app store. The native code should not be installable through an app store, as far as I know. But maybe it will change with Tizen 2.0. Maybe it will change just because you have a lot of developers who want to develop native applications, particularly the games developers who need the most of the power that they can take to developing, for example, first choose player games or things like that, even if the performances of HTML5 is quite huge and very improving any time. And the fact that we are doing an adaptation layer of Cordova API to Tizen APIs, web APIs, knowing that Tizen is anyway providing a web runtime for web applications is not having a huge impact on performance because JavaScript is quite performant at doing this. And anyway, the big issue in performance would be in the web runtime itself, mm-hmm. not really in JavaScript layer.
And then one follow-up. You mentioned that the camera support was partial.
It is partial because we were having drivers issues. I hope that I could get the hand on the new devices soon, so to improve that. And we are not supporting all the file formats, only JPEG. But for now, this the last try I did was not even getting the image. The API is implemented, the API is there. The mobile spec application says it's okay, but it is not working.
Okay, thank you.
Any more questions? So, that's it.